Every hero needs a villain, and vice versa. I really feel like Izumi and Starlight Kid need each other, and it makes either one that much better. The way I see their relationship is that they are codependent. Both are in a weird category, way more talented than the other girls their age, but still too young to be considered a legit threat to anybody in the mid and top cards. Imagine what either one would be doing now if there wasn't the other to challenge them. They would be delegated to pin fodder for the upper and middle card. Just look at whenever Izumi teams up with her faction, Queen's Quest. If Queen's Quest loses, pretty much every single time, Izumi takes the pin. Starlight Kid up until recently has been drowning in the lower card with the rookies, because who is she supposed to wrestle against? She didn't have a stable like Izumi to allow her to wrestle more talented people. They need each other, so that they can go all out and even win some matches. The way Joshi Wrestling is, each wrestler basically has a place or number. The number one will never be beaten by the number five, and so forth. While they do get wins over the younger or less experienced talent on the roster, does that really make them look good? Izumi beating one of the rookies wouldn't make her look as good as when she lost to Starlight Kid in her first title shot. I'm a big supporter of the philosophy that losing itself isn't bad, it's how you lose. If you go out there and put on an amazing show and then get beaten, I don't see you any less. I actually see you as much more than before the match. For example, when Jungle Kiona faced Viper in Nagoya on April 1st of 2018, she lost. But she seemed so strong and powerful that it didn't matter. That is exactly how both Starlight Kid and Izumi benefit from facing each other. Let's look in depth on how they complement each other more. I compared them to a hero and villain earlier, and while you could describe them that way, I don't see Izumi as a villain. They are more like hero and anti-hero, rivals that push each other to greater heights. We see it in media all the time. Goku and Vegeta, Naruto and Sasuke, Asta and Yuna, and pretty much every other battle anime. These two are the perfect foils for each other. Just look at how both of them are presented, and it's hard to not think it's purposely done. Starlight Kid is super cheery, always smiling, wears bright colors, and has a cool-looking mask. She uses very showy moves that really makes her look like a superhero. While Izumi is pretty much the exact opposite. She wears darker colors, is super bratty and disrespectful, and uses more direct attacks. When you put the two side by side, it really looks like Izumi is the shadow version of Starlight Kid and vice versa. Until both of them are older, they won't be given the chance to be near the top, so they need each other to give them a spot on the card. Instead of being pin fodder the other young girls and rookies are, they're in a class of their own, getting singles matches on big shows with each other. If you think I'm exaggerating, just look at all of Starlight Kid's three title defenses so far. Two of them have been against Izumi. There's no one else that could be taken as a legit threat like Izumi can. Let's look at some pie charts. After doing some research, I piled together the data from both Starlight Kid and Izumi's singles opponents. How many times they fought a one-on-one with each person? Around 30% of Starlight Kid's singles matches have been with Izumi, which is incredible to think about. The second place is only around 10% of her singles matches. Now, Izumi has way more singles matches than Starlight Kid, having been wrestling for much longer. Even then, Starlight Kid is only second in total matches, only being beaten by someone named Maya when Izumi first started wrestling. This just goes to show you that there is no better person to throw them against than each other. These two are going to be career-long rivals. I really feel like that. They are going to be the Io Shirai and Mayu Iwatani of their generation, number 1 and 2 running stardom. Based on the way things are right now, Starlight Kid is probably going to be number 1 and Izumi number 2. Only because of their 5 singles matches, Izumi has never beaten Starlight Kid. I was actually surprised when I saw that, but it looks to be true. In singles one-on-one matches, Izumi has 0 wins, 2 draws, and 3 losses against Starlight Kid. At the time of this video, their latest singles match ended in a draw, so I believe Izumi will beat Starlight Kid one day for her title, shifting the power from Kid to Izumi. In conclusion, these two need each other, and they are going to be better off for it. Now, I don't know the future, but that's what I honestly think. Hopefully one day we will get a very amazing main event title match for the red belt between these two at Karrikin Hall.